G'day folks, and welcome to the next episode of It's Always Beeroclock. I'm Mark.
And I'm Simon, and behind the camera we have sidekick Dave, and we're here at Freshwater Brewing in Brookvale.
You know, Simon, Freshwater Brewing is named after the nearby beach of Freshwater. It's a lovely beach. I've been there quite a few times. Do you like Freshwater?
I prefer fresh beer.
Cheers. Cheers.
Here's an interesting fact about Freshwater Beach. In December 1914, US Olympic swimming gold medalist Hawaiian Duke Kahanamoku visited Australia and demonstrated the sport of surfing at Freshwater Beach. A statue overlooking the beach commemorates the event, and the wooden surfboard used by Duke is on display at the Freshwater Surf Club. But enough of the history lesson. And back to the beer.
We're here at Freshwater Brewing Company with Johnny, one of the founders. G'day, Johnny.
Hello, how's it going? Welcome.
Thank you very much. Now, could you tell us a little bit about the history and philosophy of Freshwater?
Yeah, sure. Basically, we all live locally on the northern beaches of Sydney, and we just used to meet up and drink beers in Freshy, our home brews, and we were working in various breweries around Sydney, and just kind of were enjoying drinking our beers more than the others. And that was mainly because they were kind of crispy, easy drinking lagers. And about 3 years ago, it's quite hard to find a good craft lager, and we were just enjoying, you know, it was full haze craze back then. And I don't know, I was getting a bit of palate fatigue from a bit of hop burn, and just wanted a couple of cleansers, you know. And my wife was like, why do you work at a brewery if you're not drinking their beer, you're drinking your beer? And and that got us all kind of thinking of, like, now's the time to kind of kick on and do something. So we looked around at options and started doing some contract brewing, and got our first pilsner out. And a lot of people are like, pilsners don't sell. They don't. For us, we always wanted to concentrate on local and small, and brew beers that were relevant and fitted the climate of the northern beaches, and just easy drinking lagers and really thirst quenching beers.
Okay, now when you talk about us and we, who are the other people involved?
So kicked it off originally. I had Tommy Bruce, who's kind of head of sales. He was living in London. He was right in the middle of the lockdown there, and he got back here just in time for Sydney's second lockdown. So he was like, you got a job? And I was like, yep. And then Brett Phillips, who is our head brewer, he used to brew at Wayward and at Modus. Yep. And then my business partner, Marvin, he's kind of like the silent partner. We got speaking around the traps at homebrew events, and it was kind of us and then we've had some other core team join, but that was at the very beginning when we were hustling around the place doing contract brewing.
Okay, now I understand you've been open here for about 14 months or so. In the area, there are four or five other breweries.
Yep.
So how does that work? Do the breweries work cooperatively?
Yeah, we do. We absolutely do. So we knew when we were coming in, so we're the sixth brewery. There's a non-alc distillery and two other distilleries in the area. So it's a pretty thriving little precinct. And the thing that's different about, if you haven't been to the Northern Beaches and to Brookvale, is that it's all really close together.
Yeah.
So sometimes, when you hear about the Sunshine Coast and they've got heaps of breweries, they're all a bit of a drive or a bit, they're not necessarily that close. Whereas these are all walking distance. Like, we've got a brewery over the road, round the corner and backing onto one.
Throw a blanket over them.
Literally, if you had a tennis ball, you could hit most of them. So as a result, they're our neighbours, so naturally you get on well with them. So, we bump into each other having a coffee. We actually meet once a month and have a we share it. Each brewery hosts it.
And, all right.
Yeah, we talk about what's going on.
So a bit like a chamber of commerce almost.
Mm. Well, it started off with you've got a WhatsApp group of hey, there's some drunk guys coming around the corner wearing, silly hats or whatever. And it just sort of got to the point where we were sharing loads of information, both from a sort of logistic point of view. And then, you also borrow a load of stuff. So if you're moving stuff and you've got the equipment to help move stuff, then, or if you run out of gas, whatever, you kind of get on. So every week we're already talking naturally. And so it just got to the point where we were why don't we just make, not formalize it, but just have a little bit more of a process of look, this is what's happening. Rather than competing, complement the offer. Because that's the best thing about this area is the choice.
Yeah.
The choice is unreal. And so, if you'd said 5 years ago, to any craft beer lover, there's going to be six breweries and that many distilleries around the corner. It's it's amazing. Plus, you've obviously got the guys in Manly Vale and up in Mona Vale. So it's Northern Beaches is pumping.
Yeah, yeah. And tell me, what's the capacity of the brewery here?
It's a tricky question because we brew lagers. So if you wanted to turn over beer quickly within 3 weeks, you can pump out a lot more. But you could probably do about 100,000 litres a year if you wanted to. We're not quite there. Not far off, but not quite there. And because we lager our beers and these things, we do a primary fermentation over in the regular fermenters and then move them over to the horizontal tanks. And then that process can be anywhere from, a month to, it's very, very regular, 2 months to 3 months.
Yep.
You try and just have a pipeline of good things, and that's where you mix between ales and lagers comes in.
Right. And if folks want to buy your beer, other than here at the brewery, where can they get it?
We have our beer cartel if you don't live on the Northern Beaches. But otherwise, we're in all the independents on the Northern Beaches and then in a heap of independents in and around North Shore. We focus quite heavily on building the local sort of ground, stomping ground. I think if you lived in Manly and Freshie, you'd probably think we're everywhere because we do have a decent presence. But as soon as you start moving out from the Northern Beaches and sort of North Shore, it's quite hard to find us. We get on a few places in the city, but that's next year's ambition.
Right, okay, well, I was going to ask you, what are the plans for the next 12 months?
Hopefully exciting ones. Setting up a venue takes a little bit of energy and time.
Of course,
So it's kind of nice knowing that, this place is thriving and we've got good food and we're sort of feeling good about that. So next year is going to be growing. So next year is just going to be getting out there, going up more in Newcastle. We've started a little, Tie Hills have been great. Warners of the Bay, and we've, you know, the Carrington Bolo, they've been really good. It's just getting that little foothold in Newcastle, and then we're slowly getting into on the Central Coast. But then, yeah, we've got some other plans, potentially opening up another bar at some point next year, cash flow going well. Depends on how our summer goes.
All right, and where would you be looking at doing that, do you reckon?
Well, there's two obvious places. One's Freshwater, the other one's upstairs.
Okay.
So upstairs we've got another warehouse that we currently have a big fridge in, but we want to expand that into something more. So that's another headache, but have a good summer and we might get there.
Okay. So Johnny, maybe you could take us through your core range here.
Yeah, cool. So the first beer is our Freshy Pils. It's German Pilsner. It's got some New World hops. We wanted it, it's the first beer we thought we'd try and do something a little bit different for a Pilsner. It's just got a little bit of like a stone fruit light presence. Then the next beer off the ranks was our Wedge Cerveza. So it's a Mexican corn lager. Yeah, it's funny, brewed that 2 years ago, didn't expect cervezas to be a big thing.
No.
We saw, well, I don't know, like I saw a heap of breweries in LA and on the west coast of the United States brewing some what looked like banging, interesting craft beers that just happened to be corn lagers. And so we started giving that a crack. And, you know, the difference is in the States, corn's really cheap. In Australia, it's super expensive. So maize, if you use a certain amount of maize, A, it takes ages to brew with, because you can get stuck mash, and B, it's expensive. So if we were gonna do it, we're gonna do it properly. So we then, just to make it, rather than like a faux macro beer, we chucked a heap of Motueka and Sriracha Ace at it. So just gives it that kind of lemony sort of, you know, that flavour that is so distinctive when it comes down to Corona.
Yep. Okay.
and then our best-selling beer is our Hazy Pale. So a brewery that prides itself on its lagers and its lagering time, our best-selling beer is a Hazy Pale. But we're cool with that. Like, it fits our ethos in terms of being super crisp and easy drinking. Like, I think sometimes when you look at hazies, they can be quite thick and kind of full. This we wanted to make sure it finished dry, and so you've got a decent citrusy tropical hop aroma and flavor, but then you get that dryness, so it's thirst quenching and you want to have another one.
And is that your best-selling beer packaged as well?
Yeah, probably. I mean, I think it's interesting, all when you come up with a core range, you think, all right, let's see what happens. You put them out there, you've got a bit of theory behind it, and you see what's gonna happen. You think, well, let's see what the people, you know, when you actually have a research group over here and people can decide on what they wanna buy, you kinda, like I said to the team, let's be prepared that there might be a new member of the core range after a year.
There isn't.
Like, we do, like, our new beers do pretty well, but for whatever reason, and it's not by, you know, it's nothing to do with marketing, frankly. It's just, I think they just land in the right mix. We've got Duke's, which is our kind of like, it's a bit of a seasonal cult kind of favorite, which is a Czech Pilsner. And those four, by any one time, seem to, you know, we get, it sort of mixes it between Wedge and Hazy, both pack and hit. And then the Pilsners kind of battle it out amongst themselves. I think when it comes down to it, Freshy Pils is, from a keg sales point of view, pretty good. We've got a couple of kind of up and coming, our foam lager, which is just a crisp Heller's lager. It sits in one of these lagering tanks and can sit there for months. And you know, you wouldn't build a core range around a beer that takes 4 months to lager. It'd be stupid. But we might do it. So yeah, that's basically how we work it. I think one day, I'm sure another beer will come in and contend it, and that's what keeps it interesting. And we try and have, so we've got 14 taps, and we try and rotate them as quick as possible, just to keep it fun and interesting. Yeah. And by and large, there's always around about 9 lagers, and that can range from, like, we've got a barrel-aged lager, we've got a bock, we've come to the end of our Oktoberfest, you know. I think the days of lagers being perceived as, you know, fizzy yellow, bland beer is kind of gone. I think that, you know, this is a test space to go.
Yeah, no, I think lagers and pilsners are making a comeback.
Slowly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, well, we look forward to trying your range. Johnny, thanks for talking to us.
Pleasure, thanks for coming.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Thank you. Boys, time for our first of two tasting paddles. We've gone mostly for the core range here. Firstly, we've got the Wedge Cerveza. We've got the Freshy Pills. We've got the Hazy Pale. We've got the Duke's Pilsner, which is a Czech-style Pilsner. And we've got the Goody Two Shoes Pale Ale. But before we start, since we're having a cerveza first, I think it's incumbent upon us to do the Mexican wave. Salud.
Prost.
We're here at Freshwater Brewing with
Jared.
Jared and
Jack.
Jack. Jared, you've been here before?
Second time.
And what do you think of the place, and do you have a favourite beer?
Fantastic. It's good vibes, and the Freshy IPA was absolutely unreal. Love it.
Okay. Jack, what about you?
It's the first time here. I'm from Adelaide. So I've just come up and seen this place for the first time. Absolutely loved it. I love the Goody Two Shoes.
Goody Two Shoes?
Yeah.
Yeah, really?
So yeah, it's delicious.
Okay. All right. Well, enjoy the rest of the afternoon, guys.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. All right. We're here at Freshwater Brewing Co. with...
Jonathan.
Ian.
Ian.
Andrew.
Andrew.
Hey,
Andrew.
Go.
You've been here before?
Yeah, regular on a Friday afternoon.
And do you have a go-to beer?
I generally go for the Freshy Pills. It's, yeah, very nice.
Okay.
I change it up between the Freshy Pills and the Hazy IPA, so depending what I'm feeling like.
All right.
Yeah, definitely the Freshy Pills and the Hazy IPA would be the go-tos.
All right. Sounds like we've got a consensus there, Simon.
It certainly does.
All right. Thanks for your time, guys.
No worries.
Thank you.
All right. We're here with Jay. Jay, you've been to this brewery before?
Yeah, once before.
Okay. And what are you drinking today?
Nitro Porter.
What do you think of it?
It's pretty good.
Have you tried other beers in the range?
From here?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've had a couple.
Okay, and any of the others take your fancy?
I couldn't tell you off the top of my head. What I've had so far, I have enjoyed, so.
All right.
Good.
Well, thank you for talking to us.
No worries.
Thanks, Jay.
All good.
In addition to our first tasting paddle, we also tried the Green Room IPA, the Foam Lager, the Wedge Mezcal Export, Thunder Bock, and Nitro Porter.
Simon,
Mark.
We've concluded our visit here at Freshwater Brewing Company.
Yes, we have.
What did you think of the place?
Great atmosphere. I really like the light colours, the colour scheme, and the sort of rainbow...
The decor?
...hue of the decor. Yeah.
And beer-wise, did you have a favourite or two?
I quite like the Wedge Lager, and then it's... big sister the cerveza y mezcal.
Oh, mezcal?
Yeah.
Is that what they make tequila out of?
It is.
And of the non-Mexican beers, did you have any favorites?
I always like a black beer, and there was a black one. Love the black
beers. Right, the Nitro Porter?
The Nitro Porter, also known as the Brookvale Black.
Okay. David, your opinion on the place and the beer?
Oh, well, the place is great. Big, open, fresh, light, very welcoming for the place. In terms of the beers, I only go for the classic Bock and also the Nitro Porter.
Also known as the Brookvale Black.
Indeed, the Brookvale Black. So you can ask for either at the bar and you'll get the same thing.
Excellent.
How about you, Mark?
My favourite was Duke's Pilsner. I think it was a great example of a Czech Pilsner, and I have to admit I've been here a couple of times before and I've had that one before and I really like it. But until next time, folks, remember, it's always Beeroclock.
I'm just doing your makeup. I just don't want shiny, you know.
That's good.
I think we nailed it.
No, I think we nailed it as well.